This cathedral is beautiful, immense. We think Jeanne was baptized here, yet we don't see her in the cathedral. You must go to the back, round the choir. And finally, behind a closed grille, we find the statue in a small, dark chapel. Yet, it is an imposing statue, Jeanne, who protects the city of Bordeaux. It is a contrast between her significance for Bordeaux and the place assigned to the statue, almost in a closet.
Jeanne de Lestonnac, a member of the 16th century French nobility, niece of the famous humanist writer Michel de Montaigne, mother of five children, decided one day to leave it all and fulfill her deferred dream. She had to fight to find her way in a world of men, struggling to achieve her mission. Brave, visionary, a fighter, she founded the first female religious order devoted to education. Pope Pius XII canonized her in 1949 and named her protector of the city of Bordeaux.
Ec ego gente tempora, quibus santa Joanna de Lestonnac suam vitam traducit.
Ora pro nobis santa Joanna.
For more than 400 years, her work has spread across the world. But today, she's almost unknown in her hometown. I found it hard to accept that Jeanne de Lestonnac burned all her writings before her death. Letters and texts disappeared in the fireplace of the Rue Douai in Bordeaux. Nor did Jeanne's humility allow any portrait of her to be painted. Only her signature remained in some documents of the time. In 1697, the history of the Order of the Daughters of Our Lady was published. The Jesuit, Jean Boussonnier, succeeded in writing it after many attempts by the sisters who gathered the facts of that first century of history. It is my bedside book. Jeanne still talks to me through it. Jeanne de Lestonnac was born in 1556 in Bordeaux, France. That year, Ignatius of Loyola, founder of the Society of Jesus, dies in Rome. France is involved in a war between Protestants and Catholics. In October 1572, what occurred in Paris months before on St. Bartholomew's Day is repeated in Bordeaux. Hundreds of Calvinists are persecuted and massacred. Jeanne, at 16 years of age, lives the conflict within her family. Her father, Richard de Lestonnac, is a fervent Catholic. Her mother, Jeanne Ekem de Montaigne, is Calvinist. The evenings at her uncle, Michel de Montaigne's chateau, will mark her life. I denounce all violence in the education of a tender soul, which should be formed for honor and freedom. I assert that what cannot be achieved by reason and prudence will never be achieved by force. Though I could make them fear me, I would rather make them love me.
I was approached by my drama director. She told me that she'd be putting on the production of St. Jeanne, and I've been at this school for 11 years, and so I know all about her. I've been brought up to honour her and to respect her and to know all about the work that she did for the education of women. And so I was honoured when she asked if I would be able to play her, just because she's such an amazing woman, she's inspiring, and without her, I would not be able to come to school. One of the lines in the show is that she did not want to merely educate the children. She wanted them to grow and to know what the world is and what their place in it could be. And that has very much been continued throughout the order, throughout all of the different schools. It's not just about the grades. It's about developing yourself as a person and really fulfilling potential.
Good girls.
Jeanne's concerns about her future are answered. She perceives a voice inside her. Don't let the fire I have kindled in your heart to serve me so fervently ever die out.
I want to serve God!
But to lock yourself away from the world! Have I not taught you there are better ways to serve than that? You're a bright girl with many gifts.
My gifts are God-given!
Then why give them back to him?
We cannot have this argument again. This is best left aside.
Oh,
I'm sorry, truly, but it cannot be. I have
given the circumstances, it is not a good time for Jeanne to enter to religious life.
Your safety.
You are to marry.
Yes, it is settled. We have the bridegroom picked out. A fine young man.
But who?
I'm come from speaking with his father, the Baron de Montferrand. He has a son, Gaston, who will one day inherit the title. He has lands and money and enough to keep you safe.
But will he make me happy?
Yes, we think so.
On September the 22nd, 1573, at 17 years of age, Jeanne marries Gaston de Montferrand, Baron of Landeras, La Motte, and other places. They settle in Landeras Chateau, 40 kilometers from Bordeaux, where they will live for 24 years of marriage. and 5 of their children will reach adulthood.
La famille de Montferrand était une...
The Montferrand family was very powerful.
C'était donc une des familles...
It was one of the most powerful in Aquitaine.
Donc, c'est vrai que tout ça, on peut dire...
We could say Jeanne de Lestonnac was lucky.
Parce que, même
although later on she reverted to her maiden name Lestonnac, which was not usual at the time in France, and did not use the surname Montferrand in daily life, she remained very much part of the Montferrand family. She would never have had such influence in Bordeaux if she had not been part of the families Montferrand and Lestonnac.
They called her the good lady of Longueras. And though it is true that she was rich, she donated plots of land to people at Longueras for them to grow vegetables and have food so they could live.
Pour moi, Longueras, personnellement, je me dis, ça a permis à...
I think Longueras allowed our foundress to discover all aspects. Wife, mother, organizer, education, her pedagogy. I think there she grew the roots that made a woman out of her. But even coming from a noble background, she was able to experience the simplicity of life.
In Africa, we are a young church. We have only existed for 100 years. I compare it to the early days of Christianity. The Company of Mary is in a valley among mountains. We have an elementary school, and next door, there is a health center. As well as the elementary school, there's a high school with training for teachers. We also have a boarding school for children who come from afar. They cannot travel all the way here every day. It's a much more practical educational environment where, although they pay, the girls have to do many household tasks, among others, growing vegetables in the garden. We have a garden to grow what they consume. Then we have to buy what is lacking. Some girls don't know how to use the hoe when they arrive and go back home telling what they learned. It's a joy when their families visit them and see the place where they stay and the kind of work we teach them. When you see children arrive and see them grow, as they express their joy, you feel you have to go on. You can see that despite the obstacles, we find seeds of life. And discovering these seeds, we can go on living.
Asseyez-vous, s'il vous plaît.
Maman Malassi est-elle là?
Non, elle est sortie.
Je m'appelle Madame Bette. Je suis l'amie de ta maman.
Je vais le saluer de votre part.
Jeanne de Lestonnac's charism of education and its humanism and way of treating human beings speaks to our environment. It's not just teaching for teaching's sake. It's concerned with human beings as a whole. We also have a social educational center, which follows the principles that guided our founding sisters. They weren't only interested in the school, they wanted to help the young people who had no chance of going to school. At Moulo Social Educational Center, there are literacy classes, sewing and carpentry, to give young people a trade after their studies.
I started sewing at the Social Educational Center. Then I realized that I needed to go back to elementary school first. I studied. I went to the Adult Training Center. Then I got my certificate so that I could teach the others.
Some young people that we help are 15 years old, both boys and girls. They are directly preparing for life. Whether the person who has learned a skill is a boy or a girl, when they get married, we see the results in their family.
J'ai épousé la femme.
I got married. Sometimes when I watched my wife working, she said to me, "You could do it too." And she taught me.
She managed to communicate that to her husband. And today they complement each other. That's unusual. We are still in a system of working separately, jobs for men and jobs for women. But these examples also speak and can be a starting point for others who see them. Besides, it helps to improve the family income. De la famille. What is our mission today? It remains the same, but we try to adapt it to the specific environment. For Africans, it's about trying to get man on his feet, as we say. It means helping an individual to develop as a human being, spiritually, psychologically, so that he can be independent. We'd say like Jeanne de Lestonnac, if we had 1,000 hands, we would educate everywhere, all over the country, which also explains why we leave our country to go to other places that require us.
In a few years, Jeanne will face the death of her most loved ones, her uncle, Michel de Montaigne, her father, and in 1598, her husband and her eldest son. Widowed at 41, she has to take on the responsibility of one of the most important baronies of Guyenne and continue to educate her children.
What will we do, Mother? What can we do? We can pray. We can go on.
An efficient administrator, she will later leave the task to her second son. The peasants of the barony call her their protector.
Return to me my luggage and stop.
After her son's wedding and two of her daughters have entered a monastery in Bordeaux,
must be a better way.
Jeanne feels it is time to answer her first call.
I held a supper for some friend, and here I was, living in such audacious comfort. It did not seem just. What can I do as to redress for my fine and luxurious living?
In 1603, she leaves the castle in Landeras and goes to Toulouse. On June the 11th, she begins her novitiate at the convent of Feantine, a reformed and extremely austere Cistercian order. She intends to leave all and seek God alone. In seeking God alone, through penance and rigor, she fails. After 6 months of complete devotion and austerity, her health weakens. The doctors are categorical. She must leave the convent.
My strength seems to fail me for the moment.
It is no matter. You have given all your strength in the service of God.
Thank you, Mama.
And begin to try to discern where God will next lead you.
Mother, please! Lord! God, infinite in mercy, consoler of afflicted hearts, allow your servant to unburden the anguish of her soul in your presence. My Lord, have I been through so much trouble to reach the promised land, to only see it without entering it? My God, have I been deceived when I thought I was following your will? Do you have some other designs over me? Speak to me, Lord, in a flash you can direct my thoughts and steps along the path you wish me.
Laudation.
The night of prayer in the Feontines reflects her consciousness of her great failure.
La conciencia de un gran fracaso.
We are at a crucial moment for Jeanne de Lestonnac.
How shall I go to seek you? Tell me, and I shall fly there without stopping. I was unable to.
Es un tipo de oración en el que además se va viendo.
It is a kind of prayer where you see that from the darkest night, a perspective starts to open.
Se va abriendo una cierta perspectiva.
Stay in my heart, one and only object of my hope. Stay thee. And let me hear your voice. May I never abandon you. You never abandon those who seek you.
Al final de la oración,
at the end of the prayer, as she looks back on her life, she says, well, Lord, I'm willing to listen to you. Please, you can speak. She always has the door open for God to enter. And God does enter, and that is where he will save her. She begins to experience consolation, and something lights up inside her. She feels that God has great plans for her and for the salvation of many others.
How can I help?
will help.
Y la frase.
The fundamental point is, she understood that she was the one who had to extend her hand. From that understanding, the Company of Mary was conceived in Jeanne de Lestonnac. The fire of her apostolic passion was kindled. Her life will only be meaningful through commitment to others. She returns to Bordeaux and retires to La Motte. There she lives a long period of deep discernment. She envisages a new religious institute that will respond to the educational needs of the youth of France in the 17th century. An order where religious will serve God through the education of women in every social condition. Mary will be the inspiration of this contemplative, active life. The order of the Company of Mary Our Lady is about to be born.
It is the time of life when we ask ourselves about everything. We did what we had to do at school, in the family. Now it's time to build our lives and make our choices. We all went through it. What am I doing with my life? Who am I? What do I want? What will I do? It is also a moment in life when everything is possible. Then, at that age where everything is possible and you have the strength to invest in yourself or with others, in a society that sets obstacles, it is tough and complicated. I frequently see young people finding it hard to combine what's possible with all their aspirations and gifts. I see young people with inner difficulties because they feel questioned by it all. What values should I prioritize to get on in life? Sometimes it's a crisis of conscience. This is why I try to give them the means and opportunities, at least to see that there are more important things than those which society puts to the fore. So that they can see the situation for themselves and see their future more freely.
Avec davantage de liberté.
Watching this river flow, I feel calm. Today, I felt it was the reflection of my heart. I came to some conclusions during these days. My heart is peaceful now. But going back to Japan, my life will accelerate again. I think Japan is a country which doesn't value the individual. The tendency is for everybody to do the same at the same time. Education is very important in Japan. In a materialistic society, people have a tendency to want more luxuries without much effort. Mothers in general find it hard to educate their children.
The Japanese are very kind by culture. They do favors naturally. These are Christian values that everybody has. But it's hard. There is a lot of coldness, especially in the youth. There is a lot of indifference because they have everything. The children aren't like that. They take everything in a lovely way. And they communicate it at home.
Esto comenzó porque vimos en la sociedad el problema de que las madres estaban muy aisladas.
This started because we saw the problem of mothers not having contact among themselves. Most of the children have no brothers or sisters. So we thought it would be nice for the mothers to come with their children. Talking to each other, they realize other women have problems too. The children too, because they have no siblings. They get everything they want. And they were not getting any social education.
Entonces, no se les educaba en la cosa social. Y se vea en las mamás ambiente entre ellas que hablan y yo también nosotras podemos.
We see mothers talk to each other, and we see the mother-child relationship, so we can talk to them afterwards. I try to do it informally. The children start playing with each other too.
これです。 In
our kindergarten, we use educational material, giving particular priority to the development of independence in daily life. We constantly seek for ways to be better educators. We pay attention to their needs, trying to help them progress a little bit more every day and do things by themselves.
I did not think of coming to Japan. I asked to go to Africa. I was destined to go to Africa, and I was preparing and having injections. Then, one day, my superior suggested Japan instead of Africa. I was shocked. I had never thought about it. I saw it as a call from God, since I had never thought of Japan. Everybody said I wouldn't last a month in Japan. I don't know what happened, but after 49 years, I'm still here, and I'm very happy. If they send me elsewhere, I will go. I love the Japanese, and I think they love me too. I try to give the Christian message with my life and my joy. And with words, I do what I can.
In 1605, the plague breaks out in Bordeaux. Jeanne and a group of girls dedicated themselves to healing the sick. She shares her hopes with them, and they join her project.
Try to eat. For you. Here. So, this one here. Is he dead? I'm afraid we're too late.
In my reflections by the mill stream, I came to believe that there is a place for a community of women who hear the call but possess average strength. If you give up all your strength to God, what do you have left to give to fellow man?
Does even one such community exist, Baroness?
No, it does not.
The convergence of concerns with Jesuits fathers de Bourde and Raymond enables the project to grow. Jeanne will be able to reformulate her experience, adapting the constitutions of the Society of Jesus. In March 1606, Cardinal de Sourdis, Archbishop of Bordeaux, will approve the first formula of the order, and Pope Paul V will grant the final approbation on April 7, 1607. The Company of Mary Our Lady will be the first female apostolic religious order approved by the Vatican. Pupils and young women with a vocation will soon come. At the age of 50, Jeanne starts on a new path. Her first four companions take the habit with her on the 1st of May 1608 in the House of the Holy Spirit. 2 years later, they settle definitely in the convent school of the Rue d'Oie.
Baroness,
How was the relationship between the cardinal and Saint Jean? I think they both are people determined to pursue their aims. The cardinal has a clear idea of what he wants, but Jeanne has clear ideas too. In a way, they match their strengths.
Tell me, what else is needed to make this new order come to pass, aside from the permissions from Rome?
Well, Eminence, we would need a new house and a chapel.
On ne pouvait pas.
It was inconceivable for religious women not to live in enclosure. So she was forced to work cleverly with the cardinal and with Rome, saying, yes, we stay in enclosure as the church demands, in order to fulfill her project. But it was really difficult.
Jeanne de Lestonnac, like Teresa of Avila, these women wanted to play a part in the whole world, and they do. Enclosure is a way of preventing women from taking part in the world, or to try to prevent it. Educating girls is a public service. Therefore, it cannot be done separated by a grill. In Jeanne de Lestonnac's foundations, they designed the buildings to get round the problems of enclosure.
She had the intuition to create a neutral area where the girls could come from outside and leave again for home. When the girls arrive, every outside door is locked to observe enclosure. Then the nuns can come in from the convent. While the girls are in the building, enclosure is kept. But it is kept in a place that is not actually enclosure. We cannot say that the girls entered the enclosure, neither can we say that the nuns left the enclosure. Since they are cloistered, they cannot go any further.
Bring her here to me!
Eminence?
Mother Jeanne, I am told you are seeking to cut my authority away from me.
Elle a fait ouvrir une porte. She had ordered a door to be made. She saw it was more practical for the food to be delivered directly, rather than asking permission every time to pass through the area of enclosure.
You seek to subvert my authority!
Mais elle a fait ouvrir cette porte. But the door was made without any canonical authorization.
That doorway that you have constructed to the outside world!
The kitchen door?
That door is in direct contradiction to the rules of enclosure. It allows religious and seculars to come and go as they please.
But it does not open into any sensitive area.
Enough! That doorway is to be bricked up. And you, Mother Jeanne.
Donc, il a fait fermer cette porte. Then he had the door blocked up and ordered Jeanne to apologize publicly for her disobedience.
Demander publiquement pardon de son manque d'obéissance. Et puis de...
She was also to humble herself regularly before her community, asking forgiveness for her offense. When I knew the story, I came to see this door.
Et puis quand je suis venue sur les lieux, que j'ai vu cette porte-là. C'est vrai que d'une part, c'est symbolique.
It is symbolic. A closed door forbids entrance or openness.
Mais quand je vois comment Jeanne l'a vécu, on voit que elle a pas vécu.
Jeanne did not take it as an impediment.
Mais qu'elle a trouvé là.
It was an opportunity to open her heart in a different way.
Il me semble que là,
there, Jeanne finds a path of freedom.
Que c'est pas
des... Obstacles like that don't prevent her from moving forward. It shows the strength of her inner freedom. Her freedom was elsewhere. It didn't depend on doing this or that.
Es la fuerza de la
interior. It is the strength of the interiority that Jeanne de Lestonnac emphasized in her writing. From there, we would reach as far as history allows. The border experience will spread, and foundations will multiply. In communication by letter, Jeanne finds the means to ensure the unity of the houses. This correspondence and other documents of the time started the archives, enriched over time to the present day.
Saint Jeanne began a yearly communication of the other houses with the House of Bordeaux to foster union and mutual understanding. Through being informed about each other in this way, at least they could maintain the spirit of the whole order. Bordeaux was in charge of printing, editing, and sending out every letter received from every house.
The letter is a very feminine way to communicate. It's really close to a conversation. It belongs to the one who receives it. It's intimate and at the same time public. And of course, it relieves the enclosure. One of the most negative effects of enclosure at the end of the 16th century is that it prevents you from governing your own convents, since channels of communication with the outside world are cut. The letter works politically. It's an opportunity to bypass power and reach aims which are sometimes greater than those of power, and which are always more civilizing. Because they have that quality of fragility and seeking a way round, which is typical in women's politics. They don't send edicts backed up by an army. They send letters.
Somorrostro was a shanty town built by the sea, mostly by gypsy families. The nuns were part of this neighborhood. They taught, ran soup kitchens, and celebrated the same feast days that our schools did. They were not just ladies who knew better and taught, but ladies who cared about them, shared with them, and wanted them to progress and improve. But as the head of state didn't want anyone to see this spectacle, from one day to the next, the neighborhood disappeared. All the huts were destroyed, and the people were taken to San Roque in Badalona. The Company of Mary Our Lady built a school there for all these families. We didn't just intend to give aid. We built the best educational place we could.
Thank you.
Our school is in a very particular area of Barcelona called San Roch. It's a deprived neighborhood. It started with immigrants and has very particular characteristics. It's what nowadays is called the fourth world.
Bon dia. A veure. Molt bé. No hi ha cap L.
Pla.
Molt bé. Oh, difícil, eh, això? Vinga, ara aquí.
Hola.
Hi, I'm Namissa. Last year, I experienced for the first time the Feast of the Presentation. I really loved it, but I didn't understand much, since I had only lived in Barcelona for 3 months. When I got home, I explained that some children read and brought flowers and thought that the next year I would be able to read too. Today I'm happy to be part of this celebration. And when I get home, I will be able to explain who Saint Jeanne was and the reason for this celebration. Thank you.
It's a small sample of the kind of relationship we build here. Very human, direct, and close relationships. It is not just a neighborhood school. It's a family school. Not for the number of students, who are more than 600, but for the kind of relationships we build here. The most important challenges are fighting against marginalization and working to live together in harmony.
There was a lot of community life in the neighborhood, but this has changed, partly because of the ghettos. There are Gypsies, Pakistanis, and Chinese. The ghettos are created by the adults. It's the adults that are prejudiced. It's not the children. They play together. They are friends. They don't have a problem. These children are growing up together, and they will always be friends. So I think that in the long run, coexistence will be possible.
I see in Jeanne de Lestonnac a complete break with patriarchy. Modern patriarchy encourages rivalry among women. This was a common view until the 20th century. You cannot learn from another woman if you are her rival. Jeanne de Lestonnac brings something new to this. Only women can save women from ignorance. We're talking about friendship, communication, trust. It is precisely in this type of relationship that natural authority arises, accepting loving authority in the relationship between women and women. When a woman can acknowledge the authority of another woman, it is like being reconciled with her own mother. It gives a broad horizon. It allows for opportunities. When there's rivalry, the horizon is small and you don't learn anything. You learn to cope, but you don't learn anything that has to do with being a whole person.
Ignatius of Loyola suggests a way of looking at the world, which Jeanne de Lestonnac adopts. It's a positive look that spiritually means saying, I don't know the future or the path, but I'll search with you.
Value for the company of Mary doesn't lie in what you have to do, but what you have to be. And this is really important. Jeanne de Lestonnac is very clear that strength comes from within.
We will listen together to what the spirit tells us. It's specific to Ignatius to learn from our experience and discern our decision.
Discernment is for making a decision. Motivation is really important. The decision, with human limitations, of course, is revealed as what God wants from us at a particular moment in time. From a strong motivation springs commitment to the decision made. It implies that this is not mine, I received it from someone else, from God. So there's no room for half measures.
Y que por lo tanto ella recalca.
Therefore, Jeanne always highlighted the importance of inner strengths, from where the strength for action must arise.
Para la acción.
The Company of Mary, here in Medellin, was always devoted to the education of girls, the education of youth. They were a cloistered community. In this city, in 1968, there was the second General Conference of Latin American Bishops.
3 years after the closure of the Second Vatican Council, Paul VI traveled to Colombia to open the second General Conference of the 22 dioceses of the region, prepared by the Latin American Episcopal Council, founded in 1959 in Rio de Janeiro. It was the first time a pope had visited this church and this people.
The idea was to understand the Christian mission as a mission of liberation in a world affected by oppression. There were big changes in all communities. It was called the insertion of religious life in rural communities or in poor neighborhoods. They opened several houses. One was in the valley of the River Nus in the parish of Cristales. All the religious communities were concentrated in the cities. Very few were in rural areas. We thought this should change. Why don't we think of something different?
The religious lived in the small town, but their priority was the peasant farmers in the villages. We strengthened community work.
We never fomented hatred or resentment in the people. We helped them to improve. Once a man said to a student,
Why are you studying to end up cutting sugarcane like us? It's not worth it. And one night he called the boy to work in the mill. The boy worked all night long. In the morning, the man said, I will not pay you. Your father owes me money. The boy answered, it wasn't my father who worked all night. Then he went to the police station. They called the man and he had to pay. As he left, the student said, you see, if you study, you don't end up cutting cane like the others. People were becoming aware of their human dignity. Then the rumor started that our school was dangerous, that we educated who knows what kind of boys. The rich did not like this, because they could not get cheap labor, because people were able to defend their rights.
A jeep came to town with five well-dressed young men. They stopped at the parish and asked for the nun who did the baptism certificates. She was not there. They asked for the priest. He was not there. Then three men got into the jeep and two entered the school. They asked for the principal. She wasn't there either. Is there any other nun? They asked. She said, yes, Tere, and took them to the classroom.
She called Tere, who left the classroom. They started talking to her at the foot of the ping-pong table. The secretary went back to her office.
They must have asked Tere for something, because she went into the classroom, took a pencil and a piece of paper and left again. The men were waiting for her, one behind and one in front. When she came out, they fired the machine gun. Some children jumped from the windows. The other classes locked their doors. Meanwhile, the men left coolly. They deflated the tires of all the cars outside. Tere was still alive. She was badly injured, but still breathing. They got her into a vehicle and took her to the hospital at San Roque. She died on the way. People showed their love and concern in those difficult times. I don't think they wanted to get rid of Rosa, or me, or Tere. They wanted to stop the educational project and way of evangelizing.
Because it was hard for them when the peasants started to think.
Although they killed Teresita, they could not kill the seed already sown, which was the search for freedom, human dignity, better living conditions through an educational project and a community experience.
Nada, hay que Hay que empeñarse.
We must strive to the end. The commitment is to do or to die.
La acción.
When Jeanne de Lestonnac died on February the 2nd, 1640, the Company of Mary had founded 30 houses in France. Before the French Revolution, the company had 52 establishments in France. Years later, there was little left of the work in France. Most of the sisters had to return to their homes or were forced into exile. Revolutionaries desecrated Jeanne's corpse and took it around the streets of Bordeaux. Then they buried it next to a horse on the outskirts of the city. For years, its location was unknown.
You need to dig 2 paces to the left.
How do you know this, monsieur?
Ha! It was me who fetched him.
In 1802, Mother de Touraille begins to restore the order in France and puts all her efforts into finding the body of the foundress. She finally succeeds on November the 23rd, 1822.
Mother de Touraille had the joy of finding Jeanne de Lestonnac's body. This was important for the process of beatification and for the canonization in 1949. There was a great procession in Bordeaux to take her to the chapel where she is today. There was a wonderful celebration in the town. She was called the Saint of Bordeaux.
I believe it is a huge political gesture of Jeanne de Lestonnac to burn her personal writings and refuse to allow any portraits to be painted of her. She did not want to pass to posterity by those superficial means. She did not want the project to be objectified or focused on her. Instead, you remain in the memory, in experience, and in what others say about you, in the way you inspire them.
When I make a statue, for me it's almost like a prayer. There is a mystical experience between the sculptor and the image he's creating. The saint's head is inclined. She's looking at the girl, thinking about her. There is a simple line that shows the union between the two.
Va contribuyendo a la unidad, a la unión de estas dos personas.
The love between them.
Entre estas dos figuras. Claro,
she represents all the girls they've educated. She's not completely still. She's going forward, the child too. In life, we don't just stand still, we walk.
We have been here for 2.5 months. If the company of Mary wants to put down roots here, we need to see the land. The search is in discernment, to see how we can live our educational mission in this context. To be able to say, here is where the Lord wants us.
I think this is from God, because at 66, I'm learning my numbers and letters like a child. I'm at the stage of listening, smiling, and baby talk. It's the way to enter a new culture. You have to approach the new culture and the new country respectfully. And you have to leave aside a lot of your background and open your eyes, ears and heart with an attitude of respect and openness to discover the values of the culture of the place.
The Egyptian people are very religious. People have deep faith, whether Muslim or Christian.
Looking at the people, I see the human Jesus, present in the life of each one. In the women, the peasants, in those hands and those eyes, in their lives and suffering. I would like to convey to them that Jesus is here, that the God of life is here. That will be a long process.
When we introduce ourselves and they ask us who we are, we have learned to explain in Arabic that we are religious, consecrated to God, and dedicated to the service of others. Their attitude is, ah, that is good.
In the midst of their poverty, amidst the instability, and with their fear for the future, especially the Christians, they know how to be happy with just a few things. The poor people around the world have the same characteristics. Solidarity, joy, hospitality.
That makes me feel their sister. And I know that's what they like, because they say to us, "You're humble, you can sit here by my side." I like that. How are you, Grandma? Everything fine?
In our experience, craft helps women who are at home get together. If they enjoy it and are in a group, they talk. They start sharing their problems and getting to know each other. A woman who normally is only at home, caring for her husband and family, suddenly realizes that she can create beautiful things for herself and her children. That raises her self-esteem. I've hopes that something will come out of this. For me, the greatest gift is our community. We're building it slowly because we're very different. We're from three different nationalities with different educational backgrounds, but we're seeking together. Many people will say, "What are these three going to do?" But we trust in the Lord. I feel that is what has a future. Not believing in our own strength, but knowing that our strength is in the Lord. In Him we trust.
What appears to be fragile and weak is what will win. I believe in the power of weakness. What is weak is strong. What is strong is weak. This small community that has nothing, hidden in this remote village of Upper Egypt, is providentially preparing the future in a quiet, discreet way. Nobody is alien to the good news. It's good to go to the end of the world. Today we can be very close to each other and yet be very distant. Being on the fringes means trying to build bridges beyond differences, knowing how to develop what brings us together. We need to build fraternity.
Let there truly be water. Let there be water in the company of Mary. Let it be an apostolic torrent. And with that apostolic torrent, the strength of the water will make its own channel.